Hello designers, this is Angie from Ravener's Design Academy. Welcome back if you're already subscribed, and welcome here if you're new. Hope everyone is being responsible and staying safe. I also hope you're making the most out of your time if you're self-isolating. In this two-part video, we'll be going through top 10 free plugins that have really upped my productivity while modeling and have made things way easier. All plugin download links will be available in the description below the video. I'll be giving a brief demo of every plugin or extension as we go along. Now at number 1, this plugin is a literal tool belt called 1001 Bit Tools, the freeware version of course. It has 39 helpful tools that are very necessary if you model interiors like I do. Since there are so many tools here, I'll link a detailed tutorial for this plugin in the description box by Sketchup Essentials, but I'll show you a few things that I love about this one right now. Let's pretend this is a huge model with lots of doors and windows that I need to save time modeling. Well, this plugin has me covered because I can literally create a window or a door with a basic frame in a couple of clicks if I already have the borders drawn on a surface. The window even has a pane that can either be painted with a glass material or deleted if I plan on putting in something more detailed. Second thing I love about this plugin is the ability to create louvres in a couple of clicks. I mean, how awesome is that? Now, the third and final bit about this 1000-bit plugin is stairs. All I have to do is input correct dimension values, choose where I want my stairs to go, and voila. Basic stairs in less than a minute, with a drawn line that enables me to add railing to it later. Plugin number 2 is the front face tool. I bet you've seen me use it in a lot of my videos, and that's because it's important to have all faces positioned correctly. If you have a face in an object or a component that is facing backwards, normally you'd have to select it, right-click, and choose reverse faces. If your object is more complicated with too many polygons, that can take forever to fix. Well, this tool is here for the rescue of your precious time. Just click this button and start dragging your mouse over all backside faces. This is witchcraft in display, guys. Thank the developer of this plugin for your save time. Our third plugin in this video is Shape Bender. I have sentimental feelings towards this one because it was my first plugin ever to use, and it literally saved me from screwing up my internship back in 2014. Let's say we have a curved window opening plus a straight rectangular window, and we need those to fit. This scenario was similar to the trouble I was in when I was an intern. At the time, this looked like the end of the world for me since I didn't know how to model a curved window to save my career. So I needed a shortcut. How this beauty works is that you need to mimic the curve of your desired bend by either drawing it or copying the line. Next, draw a straight line along the length of the object you want to bend. It doesn't have to be the same length, by the way, but all lines have to be parallel to the red axis, which is the x-axis in SketchUp. The object you want to bend has to be either a group or a component, or this won't work. Select the object, then click the tool. When you do so, you'll see the tool's instruction at the bottom left of your SketchUp window. It says to select the straight line first. Next, you select the curve or bend. It takes a few seconds or minutes, depending on how complex your model is, but you'll see a green outline of your object over the bent or curved line. Because it's a mesh outline, you can't really tell if your shape is bent facing the right direction. So take note of these start and end labels and make sure that they match the start and end labels on the original object. If your shape is bent the wrong way around, you can use the up arrow on your keyboard to toggle the curve. And the down arrow to toggle the line. To draw the new object, just press enter on your keyboard. Here's our brand new shape. You can use this tool to bend literally everything into every curve imaginable. As you can see, the shape isn't aligning perfectly with the exterior because I want to match it to the interior. So keep in mind that this is not a one-size-fits-all tool, and you need to be smart about choosing which objects to bend and how you bend them. At number 4, we have the round corner tool. If you would choose one tool only out of all 10 in this video, this is the one to get, and I'll show you why. Over here, I have a generic model table, which looks a bit too crude. I'll use this tool to make it more realistic because what it does is derived from its name. I'll select the table legs and click the round corner button. An interface will pop up that has a lot of buttons. These are for a more in-depth video. For now, we'll just use the offset value and change that to something that suits the dimensions of this object. You can see a preview of where your object's corners will start to round, so you don't have to undo the whole process if it doesn't look okay. Click anywhere on the screen to apply. There we go. Why this tool is important is because if objects were this sharp in real life, they would be an injury hazard. So making edges smoother is a lot more realistic and gives your objects an overall polished look. You can see the difference between these two sets here, and it's obvious which one looks more realistic and professionally modeled. Now moving on to the planks on the table, they're all copies of one component. This time I'll choose the sharp corners button in this tool set. There's also the bevel edges option, but I'm not going for that look on my edges here. I'll adjust the offset value and apply. Can you see the difference this tool is making to a simple object? The whole object is completely different, and when I paint it with material, it will render into a realistic table. Number 5, Solid Inspector. This single button plugin can save your whole model from a lot of glitches. Let's take this newly modeled table leg as an example. It looks perfectly okay as far as we can see. Now let's inspect it. There seems to be a few problems here. There are 4 stray edges, aka troublemakers. I'll just click fix and my troublemakers are history. As for the surface border, this requires a manual intervention. What's so great about this tool is that you can inspect modeled or imported objects for errors that may lag, crash, or corrupt your SketchUp file and ruin hours of hard work. It fixes what it can't fix automatically and tells you what you need to fix manually yourself. These problems are usually highlighted in red. You just have to orbit or flip the object to see them. To save time and not overwhelm yourself, make sure you only inspect complex objects as you create them or before importing downloads into your model. It's also wise to save your progress before importing anything heavy or complex with problems, in case it causes a crash. Well, that's it for part 1 of this video. Hope these plugins prove useful to you and help you make the best of your time and skills as much as they continue to help me. Stay tuned for part 2 with 5 more plugins and extensions coming soon. Make sure you like this video if you found it useful and subscribe to get notified whenever there are new tutorials on the channel. Thank you for watching and stay safe.